Please subscribe to our channel by pressing the subscribe button and the bell icon to receive updates on new videos.
I offer my pranams to Thakur Ma and Swamiji, to everyone who's present here today on this great occasion. And I have limited time to speak today because I'm going to be addressing a few thousand people in the afternoon and the evening in Gujarat. So I have to fly out early. So I have limited time and I want to make sure that we make every minute count. It is wonderful that this morning in Hyderabad, you had so many options, but you chose to come out to celebrate the birthday of an Indian patriot monk who totally redefined India in the world, who redefined not just the glory of this nation, but also introduced to the world the great culture and civilization that we are all a part of. We go day to day in school, in college, in our workplaces, in our local communities, hearing about the greatness of India and sometimes its problems. We hear every day the men and women who we celebrate in this country and the problems and troubles that we do not like as much. But I think that in all of this, in the glory and traditions of this country, in the pride that we take in the motherland that we love, we are always called upon to reflect upon whose message, whose work has truly built this country, inspired our freedom fighters, uplifted our citizens, and it is the message of Swami Vivekananda. The message that he took from this land to the rest of the world. In 1893, last evening I was addressing a few hundred young women who had come for the youth convention here at the Ramakrishna Mutt. And I was talking about adversity and opportunity. So many times, it is the story of our lives. We see adversity in our face. We see challenges, troubles, difficulties. And we wonder whether or not we can do something good in these adversities. But it is the story of this country to see opportunity in every adversity. In the face of darkness, we choose light. In the face of challenges, we choose all options that can solve them. And on September 11, 1893, let me tell you that on our proud red fort, the tricolor was yet not unfurled. On September 11, 1893, India was still a country that was colonized by the British, who thought that civilization would come to this great land only if they existed here for long enough. When Swamiji went to Chicago, he did not carry a proud tricolor at that point, or the story of a land that today in the world is seen as a land that has given the world geniuses and patriots and saints, good science and great space science. He went to America with an image of India that the rest of the world had, that it was a country of the poor. It was a country that had so much to learn from the rest of the world. But Swamiji chose a fundamentally different story to tell. Swamiji chose to tell the story of a land that was, for thousands of years, the leader of the world in terms of culture and civilization, in terms of our indigenous knowledge, in terms of our values, in terms of what we knew before most did, and what we taught before most could. Swamiji, on September 11, 1893, delivered that one address in Chicago. There are men and women who have lived on the face of this planet. After 5 decades or 6 decades, when they pass away, even their families forget them. And look at the glory of this land. This year, all across the world, we celebrated the 125th anniversary of a speech. Not even an individual, a speech. In November, I had the great honor of being in the city of Boston, where I was for my own guest lectures. But it was the same time when World Parliament of Religions was being convened in Toronto, Canada, and the Swamis from Ramakrishna Mission were speaking there, I had the great honor of getting Harvard University to open up Seaver Hall, the same hall where Swami Vivekananda spoke in May 1894. And we had a Swami, Swami Nikleshwarananji Maharaj, from who's now with the Rajkot Center, who spoke there in the same hall where Swami Vivekananda spoke 124 years ago. This year, it will be the 125th anniversary of his speech at Harvard. Harvard is home to the world's greatest intellectuals. scientists and thinkers, philosophers. But they opened their doors for one simple reason. Because Swami Vivekananda opens the door for unity, for excellence, for glory, and for all that we can achieve as humans. Harvard could have said that we have a lot of Nobel Prize winners, we don't need you. Harvard could have said we have a lot of geniuses, we don't want to listen to anyone. Harvard could have said we have produced a lot of icons and role models, we do not want another one. But they opened their doors, they opened their ears and their hearts for one simple reason. The world needs Swamiji more today than ever before. When we live in divided times, we are divided on lines of country, we are divided on lines of state, we are divided on lines of religion and that of caste. All across the world it is a common problem. It's not an Indian problem, it's a human problem. And that is the reason why the work of an institute like the Vivekananda Institute of Human Excellence becomes so important. That's the reason why the message of Ramakrishna Math, why the work of Ramakrishna Mission becomes so important. Why the Ramakrishna Vivekananda ideology is so important for the world today. People in the West understand it. People at a prestigious university as Harvard understand it. But walk around in the streets of India. Walk into a classroom somewhere in this country. Ask a young child who your role model is. We are yet to reach many of our children. We've already lost many of our youth. And we are yet to inspire new faith an uplifting spirit in many of our citizens. That is the reason why you've not come here today as delegates. You come here as ambassadors. You have to take the message of unity, the message of excellence, the message of progress and service outside this hall. You have to take it to your classrooms, your workplaces, your houses, and there cannot be a more inspiring icon. There cannot be a more comprehensive message. There cannot be a more wholesome teaching than what Swami Vivekananda gave to us all these years and has given to the world all through. So as we celebrate the 156th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, my simple message to you is, make Swami Vivekananda's message your message. Make the call of service your call. And try and ask yourself that all these chants that we talk about and we love to chant so much, Bharat Mata Ki Jai, what do these chants actually mean? Because when we think of Swami Vivekananda, he was somebody who actually embodied the chant. When we say Bharat Mata Ki Jai, what does that mean? I know we come to these events, when we come to places where we talk about patriotism, when we talk about the country, we get very emotional about it. We get really inspired around it. And then we walk out and it is all gone. Sometimes it is very momentary. What we need to do is, the next time we hear somebody chanting Bharat Mata Ki Jai, we need to ask, what does that mean? And how can we achieve it? So that we are not just chanting, we are putting our words to action. So more young people in this country need to rise up. More young people in this country need to gear up. Because of course, with all of our glory, with all of our pride, we are also gifted with our challenges. If there is a child somewhere in this country who is out of school, it is not just the challenge of that child or that family, it is an Indian challenge. If there is a child somewhere in this country who is yet to get the kind of health care that child needs, it's not a problem of that child alone or the family alone. It's a challenge for this entire country. If there are old people in this country that need better elderly care, if there are women in this country who need more space in the workplaces or better scholarships in colleges, if there are young men who need better opportunities to either get a job or start a company, these are all Indian challenges. And these can only be solved by Indian people. And that is why Swami Vivekananda said that out of the young generation will come out those lions who will work out these problems, who will solve these problems. So instead of a complaining generation, and I think that is my message to you today, instead of becoming a complaining generation that says our roads are not good, our schools don't work, our hospitals charge too much, our media doesn't work right all the time, instead of being a complaining generation, we have this opportunity to be a problem-solving generation. Let's become a problem-solving generation. Let's reach a book to a child who needs it. A medicine to an old woman who must have it morning and evening. Better education, better healthcare, better unity, togetherness, warmth for fellow citizens. But most importantly in all of this, remember that none of it can be achieved without human excellence. So work on yourself. A lot of times we walk outside preaching lessons, teaching people stuff, while we fail to implement it in our own lives. So the challenge we'll continue to have is, how do we gain that human excellence? You are gifted, you are blessed that you are right here in the heart of Telangana, in the city of Hyderabad, where you have the Ramakrishna Math. Feel free to drop by to pick up a book at the library, to take a book home from the bookstore, to meditate in the shrine here, to sign up for classes at the VIHE. Because this will help you gain the excellence that you need within you, so that that excellence can shine outside of you. So today, as we celebrate National Youth Day, I hope that you'll not just take chants as chants, you'll try and convert them into real messages, that you'll not just take these celebrations as celebrations, you'll realize the task that we are called upon, and that you'll not take the greatness of this country for granted, you'll take it forward, you'll reflect on men and women who have helped us earn this greatness for this country, and finally, you'll not just take these challenges that we face as just mere challenges, you'll try and solve those. So in conclusion, all I have to say is that we have moved into a new century. Today, our problems are not just limited to what we do in our houses. It is also about the planet. It is about nature. It is everything that we see. We need to make sure that as we continue to serve others, we continue to serve our planet. There are challenges where we need to see that as we use nuclear energy to bring more electricity or better power, we make sure that nuclear disarmament continues to happen at the same time. So there are going to be 21st century challenges. Global warming, nuclear disarmament, reaching better education, technology in every house. And for a 21st century challenge, we need a 21st century leadership. And there's no book of thought, no school of thought that I can imagine that can actually empower a 21st century leadership that has empathy on the inside and excellence on the outside than the Ramakrishna Vivekananda ideology. We need people who are going to be strong decision makers, strong leaders, who'll be excellent in whatever they do, and they'll need empathy on the inside. So do simple things today. Do not just put up a selfie or a social media post. Today, make sure that you start a habit, and that habit has to be service. Be willing to serve, and know that being of service to others can be defined in many ways. Teach a child a math problem. Teach a child how to play badminton better. Help an old lady cross a road. Help somebody who is illiterate write a letter to be better represented. Do all these small acts of service. They grow you as a person. And continue to read more about Swamiji's life. Read more of his message. And don't just be somebody who takes in the message. Be an ambassador for that message. Take that message of unity. Take that message of excellence. And take that message of service to the rest of the world, just like Swamiji did 125 years ago. Just like the life that we have celebrated for 156 years now. India has been blessed that it had Swamiji. We need to prove that we deserved him. Thank you so much, everybody. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.